my mic as usual is muted. Hi, hey everyone, how are you guys? What's up? I hope you can see me and everything's okay. Oh my god, already there are people in the chat asking for chess books. But guys, let me give a short disclaimer here, which I have put in my description as well, कि ये non-chess stream है. मैं life में और भी चीज़ें करती हूँ other than chess, and I just wanted to talk about non-chess books. I'll do a chess book stream perhaps, but today it's a non-chess stream, only fiction books, not even non-fiction. Confession that I don't read much fiction. Actually have not read any fiction books in the past 4 years. And even the last fiction book I read was something I reread rather than read it for the first time. I had read this book as a child and then I decided to read it. But I wanted to do the stream because I wanted to talk about some of my favorite books, which were super influential on me as a child and as a teenager. And till a certain age, I obviously only read fiction books. I think all of us read only fiction books till a certain age. And I also wanted some book recommendations from you guys. Also, I was thinking, why am I wearing headphones? I don't need them. So, Nilay Arya says, not even Harry Potter. We'll get to that, guys. We'll get to that. Yeah, so the first book that I want to talk about is ta-da, this one. Is my screen mirrored or something? I think my screen is mirrored. Wait, let me unmirror it. Just one moment, because I want you guys to see the, yeah, I don't want to mirror my screen. Yeah, better. But the mirror screen looks real, no? This looks like artificial, I don't know why. Mirror screen looks real somehow. I get Samay's obsession with this flip horizontal. I get it. Because it looks very weird on the OBS. When you have to see yourself, and now I find it very weird to anyway. So I wanted to show you this book, Alice in Wonderland, who I think everyone has read it in their childhood, and it's like one of the most commonly read books all over the world, along with Jungle Book, I guess. Maybe Jungle Book is special to India now, I'm thinking. But at least Alice in Wonderland to sabne padha hai. And it was a huge influence on me when I was a kid. I was very imaginative as a kid. And I think it's partly because of all these nice books that I read. Like Alice in Wonderland and uska part 2 hai, Through the Looking Glass, this one. And then Jungle Book. And I used to have... we had this whole series of childcraft at home, aur usme bhi bahut sare aise books the, Black Beauty, and aise acche acche books the, Trojan Horse ka story bhi tha, even though that's a legend actually, wo bhi tha usme. So but I wanted to talk about this book in particular because I think it's very relevant even today. Like, I can read this book even today. I think it's not a book for kids, but for all of us. Because, hear me out, it's like a philosophical book, according to me. I'll explain it. I know it sounds like it's just for imagination. You know, Alice thinks of 6 impossible things before breakfast. And, she follows this rabbit who can talk, who has a watch, who has a pocket watch down the rabbit hole, you know. And she's like, how does this rabbit talk and how does he have a watch and you know what's happening? But I think it's very philosophical because there are a lot of things in the book, you know. For example, there is a chapter in the book in Alice in Wonderland only, not Through the Looking Glass. Alice in Wonderland, there is a chapter in which she meets a caterpillar, okay? And the caterpillar asks her, who are you? And by now she has, you know, gone down the rabbit hole. She has become smaller. She has become bigger. She has gotten lost. She has even thought to herself, maybe she's one of her friends. And she has thought of all the other girls she knows of her age. And she has thought to herself, maybe she has changed into one of her friends. And then, you know, she thinks to herself, no, but this girl is not as smart as me. No, I know a little more than this girl. So I must not be that girl also. So basically, what she realizes is that she is very unique. She's not like other people, you know. And I think that's what we realize, no? At some point, we realize that we needn't compare ourselves to other people. We are unique by ourselves. And then when she meets this caterpillar, that caterpillar asks her, who are you? And she says, I don't know who I am. And she also says that... I don't know if I'll make the same decisions today as I made yesterday, because I was a different person then. So what she means to say is that she's constantly changing as a person, and that's why what she wants today may be very different from what she wanted yesterday. Obviously, in the book, it's all exaggerated, you know, wo ek din mein badi ho jati hai, choti ho jati hai, bahut kuch ho jata hai uske saath. But that's how we, like, life is, na? Hum constantly change ho rahe hai. Toh 10 saal pehle jo humko chahiye tha, not necessary, we want that even now. And 10 saal pehle kisi ko kuch bola, abhi usse relate bhi nahi kar sakte, you know. The, pehle jiske upar crush tha, abhi sochte, pata nahi kyun uspe crush tha, pata nahi kaise log pasand aa jate the mujhe, you know. These kind of, so we are like constantly changing. And one more thing about this book is that in Through the Looking Glass, that is the second part of the book, she comes across the Red Queen, okay, in the first chapter itself, I think this happens. And, you know, the Red Queen, ek toh obviously chessboard, chess ka theme hai na, queen hai, usme Red Queen rehti hai, White Queen rehti hai. And the Red Queen has this, estate or empire, right? Anyway, so she looks at it and she realizes that the empire, uska jo field hai, it is divided in such a way that it looks like a chessboard. And she asks the Red Queen, so can I also participate in this game? It looks like a chess game, and can I also participate? So she says, okay, you can be the white pawn and on the second rank, you know, and when you reach the eighth rank, you'll become the queen. Because, so she's like, okay, fine. So she goes and stands at the second square, huh? And then the Red Queen holds her hand and they are like running really fast. Yeah, they're running really fast, like imagine. And थोड़ा time चला जाता है, कुछ 15 minute हो जाता है, and then the Red Queen says, okay, fine, done, अभी रुक जा. And then when she stops, she realizes she's still at the same place, you know, she's still beneath the same banyan tree, she's still at the same place and the same second rank. And she was like, अरे, in my world though, if I had run so fast, I would have reached somewhere. We didn't reach anywhere. And the Red Queen tells her, well, that's strange, you know, over here, if you run really fast, then you manage to stay at the same place. And Alice says, but then how do we go to the other place then? And the Red Queen tells her, well, for that you have to run twice as fast. So it's actually a metaphor, right? Like if we are, like chess mein bhi main bahut baar sochti hu, I'm working so hard, why am I not getting anywhere? But the point is, if I work really hard, then I can actually just maintain my level. And if I have to improve it, I have to go to the next level, then I have to work twice as hard. So I think it's like a super philosophical book. And everyone should read it, whatever age you are at. And I actually would love to read it anytime. One more funny thing is that one of my dear friends, Vera Nebolsina, she's a woman grandmaster from Russia. And how we became friends, she's also a former world junior champion. How we became friends is that we both were around 25 when we first interacted with each other. And one of our first interactions was over this book, Alice in Wonderland. And you know, at 25, you don't expect someone to like Alice in Wonderland, right? Like, you're like, कितने बच्चों का बुक है? But to just meet another person who likes the same book as you, and we had like so many discussions over this. So even this, I really like one quote. I really like one quote from the book where Alice is at a crossroad and you know she has to choose where to go and she doesn't know where to go. She doesn't know which road to take. So then the Cheshire cat, it pops up there. ठीक है, ऐसा वो फ्लोट करते रहता है वो कैट and it pops up there and it asks her, she it's just looking at her and smiling and smirking, क्या बेवकूफ बच्ची है, you know. And then Alice asks the Cheshire Cat, okay, which road should I take? Can you please help me? And the Cheshire Cat tells her that, where do you want to go? So Alice says, I don't know, because she's genuinely lost. She doesn't know where she wants to go also. So the Cheshire Cat tells her, well, if you don't know where you're going, then any road will take you there. So the point is to first decide where you want to go and then decide which road to take, rather than decide which road to take and then decide where you want to go. So a lot of deep stuff in these books, and I think even adults should read it. What someone is like commenting, please rate PewDiePie. So, how many of you have actually read this book? Thadani Govind is spanning a lot. Can you please not spam? Like, I would really request you. Okay, I've read your comment that your phone was hacked and that's why कुछ तो मैसेज भेज दिया लास्ट वीक. ठीक है, नो प्रॉब्लम. अभी आप प्लीज स्पैम मत करना, ठीक है? और अपना फोन ठीक से रखना, बिल्कुल उसको किसी और के हाथ में मत देना. ओके, सो नाउ मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट बुक. ओ, माय फेवरेट कोट, मैगी काप सेज, माय फेवरेट कोट इज, वी आर ऑल मैड हियर. या, माय मैड हैटर एट मैड हैटर्स टी पार्टी. या, इट्स ऑल द गुड पीपल आर स्लाइटली मैड, ऐसा कुछ बोलती है ना एलिस मैड हैटर को. शी टेल्स हिम अ सीक्रेट. और उसके ऊपर एक मूवी भी बना था एक्चुअली. आई थिंक जॉनी डेप प्लेड द पार्ट ऑफ मैड हैटर. नाउ आई फेंटली रिकॉल इट, आई फेंटली रिकॉल इट. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट बुक आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट इज दिस वन, काइट रनर. आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू ऑल्सो मस्ट हैव रेड दिस वन एज वेल. It's like a complete mood shift now from Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland is like dreamy and all kinds of, you know, a make-believe world and सब अच्छा अच्छा होगा तुम्हारे साथ kind of world. And then now suddenly talking about Kite Runner. But I love this book. I love this book. I think it was released around the time when I was about 15, 16 years old. I was a teenager. And I think it's the right age to read this book actually because it's a little heavy. So if any kids are watching, I would recommend you wait till like 15 or 16 and then read this book. It's a little difficult to read because a lot of they go through a lot of tough moments. So it's basically set in Afghanistan, the story in Kabul, before it was invaded by the Russians. And I think it was before it was invaded by the Russians, right? Yeah. And The main character is there are is Amir, who has a friend called Hassan, and the story revolves around. I think it revolves around two things. One is the relationship of Amir with his dad. Like the whole throughout the story, he's trying to gain his father's, like throughout his childhood, he's trying to gain his father's affection and approval. और उसको हमेशा लगते रहता है कि you know, he wants his father to be proud of him, basically. Which is a very natural feeling any child will have, especially his mother is no more. So in that case, even more, right? Like usko bachpan se uske daddy uska sab kuch hai. And it's also about redemption, because Amir basically commits a mistake in his childhood, and he like spends much of his life in regret, you can say, as to why did he make that mistake. And then in towards the end of the book, he gets a chance to redeem himself, and it feels so good to see him redeem himself, you know. And I was really, really touched by that book, because it also gave me a lot of hope that even if you make like a very big mistake in life out of your innocence, or you know, sometimes ignorance, or you just in the moment make a huge mistake in life, you do get a second chance. You do get a second chance in life to correct it, and you should not let that second chance go. So it gave me a lot of hope, that book. And there's one more, of course, very beautiful thing in the book is a conversation between Amir and his dad, whom he refers to as Baba. And his dad tells him that, like, his dad is generally giving him advice, I think. And his dad tells him that he's talking about morals, you know, he's talking about morals. And he says that when you tell a truth, when you tell a lie, sorry, when you tell a lie, you rob another person of his right to the truth. And I thought that was so well put, and it's such a convincing advice, you know. You would take it, you would take it. Like whenever you lie, you think to yourself after that, "Arey, I'm depriving this next person of his right to truth." And so you just tell yourself, "No, I should be brave enough and just tell the truth," you know. Vishal, you've not read, what are you saying? You have not read Alice in Wonderland or The Kite Runner. You should read it. Please read it. Please read it, Vishal. Okay, depends on your mood, actually. Because books are very mood-oriented, you know. You can't read any book anytime. So that's the reason I'm giving some kind of context here, so that you can decide which book to read depending on your book. I really liked, so back to what I was saying was, I really liked the way he put it. And he also says that when you cheat someone, you're stealing that person of his right to fairness. And I mean, the way he says it, you know, it's so convincing. And actually, when I was a kid, I could not even... लाइक अभी थोड़ा मैच्योरिटी आने के बाद समझ में आता है लोग झूठ मूठ क्यों बोलते हैं, पर बच्ची थी तभी समझ में भी नहीं आता था, व्हाई डू पीपल लाई. लाइक आई कुड नॉट इवन अंडरस्टैंड प्रैंक्स. एक्चुअली आई यूज टू थिंक लाइक व्हाई वुड समवन लाई टू मी, यू नो. सो इट रियली रेजोनेटेड विथ मी, दिस एडवाइस ऑफ हिज दैट यू रॉब समवन ऑफ द राइट टू ट्रूथ. एंड आई रियली लाइक द बुक. आई थिंक इट फिल्स यू विथ होप. एंड इट ऑल्सो लाइक teaches you a lot about a world which you hardly know, right? Like Afghanistan. Who has been to Afghanistan? Very few people. I mean, from India, and especially So you get to learn a lot about what kind of life they had, and it's a completely different world. And it's called the Kite Runner because they really like flying kites when they are kids, and it's like a culture there to fly kites. So yeah, very beautiful book, totally recommend it. The third book is also in this genre. It is this one, Great Expectations by Charles Dickens. I love this book for the title, first of all. I was super attracted to reading this book as a child because of the title and because it was written by Charles Dickens, and we had a lot of his books at home. They were like these children based, like, you know, there are versions, right? Like child versions and adult, like the real book. So I actually read the child version when I was a kid. And I read, this is the last fiction book I read, by the way. I read it in 2016. I obviously had read it as a child, the child version of it. And I really had liked it so much. Because I think that this book also filled me up with a lot of hope. I felt the same the second time as well. But the second time, I was an adult already, so I could understand it much more. So it's basically about an orphan named Pip, lives in England. And usually all of Charles Dickens' main characters are orphans only, because he himself had a tough life. So he has a very tough life as well, this kid, Pip. But then he's quite poor. He thinks he's going to become a blacksmith only. He's raised by his older sister and her husband, who's actually a very nice man, who's a blacksmith. And Pip thinks he'll also become a blacksmith only. Na abhi, what can he achieve in his life? Then in his village, there is a very wealthy and sort of strange lady called Miss Havisham, who lives all alone in a huge mansion. And then she also has an adopted daughter named Estella, who's extraordinarily beautiful. She's very, very beautiful and very, very arrogant. And Pip sees her. Pip is this nice, sweet, innocent boy. Pip sees her when they both are kids, they are around the same age, and falls in love with her immediately. He's like, wow, itni sundar pari, you know. He's like completely fida over her. And it's very sweet, actually, the story, because Pip is so innocent and he really loves her. Like, aise shiddat se mohabbat karta hai uske upar, aise nahi ki upar upar se, you know. He genuinely loves her, and it kind of makes you feel like, achha, someone can really love you like so much, like with all their heart, no matter how you are, whether without judging you. Because actually Estella is super arrogant, and she has been raised like that, you know. She has been raised like that by her mother, to be mean to people, and, you know, like be mean to guys, and just use her like beauty to her advantage, you know, like not be very kind and whatever. But Pip like doesn't judge her at all, and he just sees all the good in her. Usko bas usme achcha hi dikhta hai. And I think because of this goodness in Pip, she also starts changing, and she also becomes nice, because when someone has so much positive energy towards you, you also kind of receive it, right? And change. So yeah, I'm talking so much. I'm like, so yeah, I really love this book. And another lovely thing about this book is that Pip actually makes something of himself in his life. Aise nahi ki wo blacksmith hi reh jata hai. He goes to the city, he becomes a big man, and there's also a mystery. Like, he receives a mysterious sort of scholarship, like a stipend from someone every month, and he doesn't know who is sending it to him. So it's a very nice book and it has all these quirky characters. And I think what I learned from the book is to not judge people. That is what I learned. And also what I learned is that it is possible to love someone like with all your heart. And it's like unconditional love, you know. He doesn't expect her to reciprocate it or something, which is very sweet. Also, fun fact, why I read this book was, again, like the second time, was there was a movie coming, a Hindi movie coming in on this, like an adaptation of Great Expectations. It's called Fitur, okay? This is a Hindi movie. Maybe if you guys want, you can watch it. Maybe you watched it already. Songs to dekha hi hoga, bahut famous hai. Katrina Kaif hai usme. And Aditya Roy Kapoor, very good looking people. So very good looking movie in general. It was like trashed by everyone. Like kisi ko pasand nahi aayi somehow aur jyada chali nahi. But I thought it was a great movie. Kyunki mujhe ye book bahut pasand hai. और मैंने एक्चुअली वो मूवी देखनी है. आई वॉज वेरी हैप्पी कि वाओ ग्रेट एक्सपेक्टेशंस पे मूवी आ रही है. तो मैंने सोचा ये बुक पहले पढ़ेंगे फिर वो मूवी देखेंगे और कंपेयर करेंगे. मतलब देखो मेरे प्लान्स. या सो आई डिड ऑल दिस एंड देन आई सॉ द मूवी एंड एक्चुअली इट्स अ वेरी वेल मेड मूवी. आई थिंक टब्बू प्लेज द रोल ऑफ मिस हैविशम एंड शी इज ग्रेट. कटरीना इज परफेक्ट. शी इज परफेक्ट एज एस्टेला. उसका लाइक शी इज सपोज यू नो देर वॉज लाइक अ ह्यूज क्रिटिसिज्म फॉर हर. लाइक शी इज वेरी शी हैज नो एक्सप्रेशंस और कुछ एक्टिंग नहीं करती है मूवी में. बट शी इज सपोज टू बी लाइक दैट यू नो. एस्टेला इज सपोज टू बी वेरी कोल्ड एंड वेरी लाइक डिटैच्ड और उसको कुछ अफेक्ट नहीं करता है. कोई कितना भी उससे प्यार करे वो घास नहीं डालती है किसी के ऊपर. पता है लाइक शी इज वेरी लाइक दैट एंड शी इज वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड like very graceful. And Katrina is perfect. She's perfect in that part. She does it such a great job. I thought it was a great movie but somehow didn't work because I genuinely feel nobody understood it. That's my honest opinion. So the fourth one now I'll go. Have you guys read it, by the way? Someone is saying, why not David Copperfield? I actually read the child version of David Copperfield as well when I was a kid, but I didn't read it recently, so I don't remember much of the story. Oh, and someone asked me, have you read To Kill a Mockingbird? No, I didn't. You know, I had the copy of it for a really long time. But I gifted it to my, I lent it to my friend. And my friend never returned it. Which is like the usual case, yeah, with your books. That's why you should never loan your books. You should, this trick I have learned from Paddu. Padmini, who will be joining us shortly, she advised me once that if you really like a book and if a friend of yours, you know, comes to check out this book and they're like, "Are wah, can I take this book?" You can just say no, but you can give that person that same book, like just order it for that person so that they'll never take your copy and they have that book as well. Because once you loan your book to someone, it's never coming back. That's for sure. Okay, so now the fourth book I want to talk about, which uska copy mere paas yahan hai nahi. I'll drop something. jiska copy mere paas yahan hai nahi. But just one second. Sorry, I had to reply to a message. So, the fourth book was The Alchemist, which everyone must have read again. And if you haven't read it, please read it, guys. It's not even like a fiction book. It's like a motivating book. Matlab, itna acha book hai. and it fills you up with hope, and it fills you up with like, I can also do it, you know, this kind of spirit. And I have a very funny story related to this book, which I had once mentioned on one of the streams, that when I read this book for the first time, I think the first, I had read it like 2-3 times already. Like once I read it once, then I again reread it. And that time I was seeing someone, and I thought to gift my then boyfriend this book. Okay? And it was so funny. I gave that book so much love. पढ़ लो, इतना अच्छा बुक है, तुमको बहुत मोटिवेशन मिलेगा, यू विल फील वेरी इंस्पायर्ड इन लाइफ एक्सेट्रा. एंड दिस बॉय ही रिटर्न द बुक इन 2 days. आई एम लाइक, 2 दिन में पढ़ ली बुक इतना फास्ट, बिकॉज ही वॉज नॉट लाइक अ बिग रीडर और समथिंग, यू नो, आई न्यू दैट ही डिडंट रीड मेनी बुक्स. आई वॉज वेरी इंप्रेस्ड, अरे वाह, तुमने 2 दिन में बुक पढ़ लिया. एंड देन आई वॉज ऑल्सो लाइक, हाँ, मेन मैंने ऊपर से पढ़ लिया. आई एम लाइक ऑलरेडी आई एम अ लिटिल डिसअपॉइंटेड, ओके, क्योंकि ये बुक मतलब इट्स अ स्टोरी, इट्स नॉट लाइक अ सेल्फ हेल्प बुक की बस मेन चीजें पढ़ लो, यू नो, इट्स अ स्टोरी, यू हैव टू रीड इट फुली. सो देन आई टोल्ड हिम कि नहीं, पर तुम्हारे लिए बुक, बिकॉज आई ऑलरेडी हैव 2 मोर कॉपीज, सो यू कीप दिस बुक, इट्स फॉर यू, इट्स अ गिफ्ट. And then he says like, no, this book is for you, you read this one only. And I was like, why should I read this copy? And then he made me open it, and he had actually like underlined all the things that he thought was important. And he wanted me to now read this book from his perspective, which I thought was too much. And I was like, sorry, like, oh my God, itna main nahi karne wali hu. So, ye cheez kabhi mat karna, guys. उस दिन मैंने सोचा कि जब ये लड़का, लाइक उस दिन नहीं बट जब हमारा ब्रेकअप हो गया, उस दिन मैंने सोचा था कि जब ये लड़का शादी करेगा तो मैं उसकी शादी पे इतने सारे बुक्स देने वाली हूँ, और सब अंडरलाइन करके, यू नो, आई जस्ट अंडरलाइन ऑल द मेन पार्ट्स, एंड आई लाइक गिफ्ट हिम 1 dozen बुक्स जस्ट सो दैट ही रीड्स दोस बुक्स फ्रॉम माय पर्सपेक्टिव. Anyway, so don't do this, guys. Very bad idea. Great way to lose whatever chance you have with your girlfriend. And why everyone has read Alchemist also, I think, but still I'll talk a little bit about it. It's about a poor shepherd boy who lives in Spain in Andalusia. And he has this dream of a treasure one day, you know, and he makes a whole journey to find that treasure, you know, he goes to Egypt and everything, you know, he just, because he, in his dream, he also sees the Egyptian pyramids, so he feels it's near the pyramids, and you know, from Spain to the pyramids, he makes a whole journey, and it's amazing, and he encounters so many experiences in his journey. And it's about whether he finds the treasure or not, and how he finds it, if he does, and what happens in the end. It's amazing. And I think everyone also knows this very famous quote from the book, which is, when you really want something, the whole universe conspires for you to achieve it. Which is very true. If you really, really want something, it can actually happen. And somehow everything just falls in place. When it's happening, you don't realize it's happening. But then when it, one day you realize, why did everything come? Like, you just realize how everything got together. So it's also about like just believing that everything happens for a reason, and just believing that it's going to happen. So yeah, I really, really liked this book as well. And I read it when, around the same time, when I was a teenager, like 2007 or 2008. So, now that we have spoken a bit हाँ शाहरुख का डायलॉग है, करेक्ट, पर शाहरुख ने वो एल्केमिस्ट से ही लिया है। मैंने इतनी शिद्दत से तुमसे मोहब्बत की है कि व्हाट इज इट, मैंने इतनी शिद्दत से तुमसे मोहब्बत की है कि सारे जमाने ने मुझे तुमसे मिलाने की साजिश की है, राइट? दैट इज इट, नो? आई थिंक दैट इज इट। ओके गाइस, नाउ इट इज टाइम टू इनवाइट माई गेस्ट हु आर हियर। आई होप मेरा मेरा जूम अभी थोड़ा ये होने वाला है, बट इट्स ओके गाइस। मे बी आई विल जस्ट हाइड माई स्क्रीन। हेलो,
हेलो, हाय हाय
हाय। आई कांट सी ईदर ऑफ यू। ओके
हाय
नाउ आई कैन, बट फद्दू आई
हाय
कांट।
हाय हाय म्याओ हाय श्रीनाथ
हे,
हाय
हेलो
हाय
हेलो
हाय ऑल ऑफ
हेलो।
यू
ओके वेट, नाउ लेट मी गेट यू गाइस ऑन द स्क्रीन बिकॉज वेट, हाउ डू आई वेट गाइस, आई गेट श्रीनाथ एंड फद्दू द स्क्रीन।
So nice to join
ओपीएस,
streams on Zoom like this.
या विदाउट हैविंग टू डू ओपीएस, नो? आई नो, इट्स लाइक अ रिलीफ। वन सेकेंड, लेट मी क्रॉप। द थिंग इज,
So Padu, what's up? How's it going?
कैन यू हियर दैट बाय द
Great.
वे? वेट लेट मी चेक इफ
Going
दे कैन।
great.
ओके मेबी आई कैन जस्ट लाइक डू
Yeah, should we talk about
अस
Chessable and Catalan and stuff, or should we be
चेसेबल,
specific to fiction books?
चेसेबल एंड कैटलान। ओ या, प्रमोशन ओपी गाइस, यस, बाय बाय, व्हाई नॉट? जस्ट वन मोमेंट।
Actually, just before joining, I was watching your stream. And I thought to myself, this is one of those streams which I'll never watch because it's
Why?
full of spoilers.
Really? I spoiled what for
Oh
you?
yeah,
Okay,
do
for
no?
what
Like
have I
Alice
spoiled?
in Wonderland, I have not read, so
Oh
I
my
skipped that
God,
part.
Paddu,
Okay, I know,
yeah,
I know, I know, I know. But
Paddu, Paddu, please, I'll gift you today only.
so
I'm
you have
bored.
already gifted me
Oh my God, this is meant too
it.
much.
Yeah, but like I think long back in school it was there in one of the chapters, but I don't really remember it.
Pink screen.
Yeah, it used to be in non-detail, no?
Yeah, exactly. It used to be in non-detail.
CBSE, I
Thank
think.
God. I'm like, this is like cropping is like amazing. What non-detail kya hota hai?
Non-detail stories. So it was like Non-detail
this
was, yeah.
tiny English book which we had, like Huh.
some, it was of 20 marks, right? Or something.
Oh my God. Okay.
I guess it was part of the English subject.
Yeah,
You know,
part of
like
this one English book.
how social has civics.
I'm the only one who's not on screen now. Wait. Got you
Yeah,
both.
so there used to be all these classic stories and there some question would come for like 20 marks or something.
Oh. And Alice in Wonderland was one of those books, is it?
One of those chapters, like not books, but chapter.
Haven't done a great job of cropping, to be very honest, but it's okay. Just one moment. What is it like this? Like half of my head can't be seen. Why?
You're capturing it from oh, how are you capturing it? This looks strange.
Very strange it looks, no?
Yeah.
Yeah, my head can't be seen. I don't know why. Okay, wait. Maybe I'll just wait, huh? Maybe I'll just do one thing.
Is your video capture behind this background or you know, like in your OBS, you have these sources, right? So is your video behind the image you have or in front? If the image is ahead of your video capture, then that will cut off a part of it maybe.
The complicated question pucha hai. I don't answer. It's cutting off my head. I don't know why. But it's okay. I think this is fine. Sort of. Just see now. Just see now, guys. Is this okay? See the screen now.
Where? On the stream?
Huh.
No.
Not okay. Now.
Your head is cut.
Oh, off. Maybe I can just tilt the camera. That's true. Smart. It's okay now. Now it's okay.
Yeah.
I have to like maybe. Shift.
Yeah,
a bit,
yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I have to shift a bit. Abhi theek hai. See, you are seen clearly. Paddu is also clear. Me also clear. This is good. Theek
hai. Yeah. Now I see him. Yeah. Fantastic. Good? Yeah.
Lock it, huh? I'll lock it.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what's up, guys? So, the fifth book that we want to talk about with Paddu and Srinath is, can you please guess?
Catalan.
Okay. No, this is a non-chess stream, Shri. I announced it in the beginning itself ki chess books, chess yahan pe discuss nahi hoga.
We're not talking about Wizard Chess today, is it?
Wizard Chess, no. Not about we are not talking about Wizard Chess tour, which is starting from
Wizard Chess.
Oh, Wizard Chess. Yeah. But we when is your Catalan, by the way, releasing?
Sometime in March.
Okay. So we are not going to talk about that as well. It's the fact that it's releasing in March on Chessable. Yeah, we are not talking about that as well. So, nobody's guessing, yaar, what we are going to... Yeah, okay. Harry Potter.
How can
yeah.
I not guess? I'm talking from outside of my school, from where I just got a special permission to join the stream.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Paddu, did you see?
Yeah, I saw. But it's. I think you could just be stream it from inside, no? It would have been much more cooler from the Hogwarts.
Yeah, but inside it will just look like an antique room, no? How will people make out the difference? So I'm at the Forbidden Forest right now.
Okay.
There are some
Can't see any trees, but that's okay.
That's in front of me.
Okay. Like, yeah. So you're just.
I have mounted my camera on top of a tree. Also, there are a lot of things you won't be able to see because it's protected by special charms and stuff.
You don't need any webcam, no internet. You just need magic, Srinath. What is this?
Yeah, I'm like Arthur Weasley, you know. I like to play around with these muggle
You like muggle
objects
stuff.
And stuff. Yeah.
Like specs, which wizards don't need. But Harry is the only one, by the way, trivia.
I read it somewhere and I was so shocked that Harry is the only one with specs.
Wearing specs, yes. It's just for style, I think. Why would a wizard need specs? He can just autocorrect his vision, no? Like,
I don't know. Is it possible?
I mean, if they can fix a broken hand in a night, then everything is possible.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, the bones can mend, but cornea doesn't.
Laser surgery, tab tak unhone discover nahi kiya tha, shayad.
97,
not so advanced, huh?
Yeah.
By the way, do you know, so Harry Potter, I read Harry Potter exactly when I was 11.
Wow. That's quite early.
That's the correct age to read Harry Potter. I just got lucky that exactly when I was 11, I got my hands on Harry Potter books.
Paddu, how old were you?
So my story with Harry Potter is like really, really weird. You guys won't believe it.
Hmm.
So I think you remember when we were playing in Balaguer in 2007?
Huh.
So that was the time when the seventh book had come out.
Hmm.
And all the girls in our group were talking about Harry Potter, Harry Potter, and like trying to, you know, give some spoilers. But I was that time least bothered because I had not read any books. I didn't care who died, who lived. I didn't care absolutely, even if I overheard any of the spoilers.
Hmm.
I think probably I had watched the movies during the Telegraph School Chess Tournament. They used to, you know, screen the movies after the closing ceremony.
Yes.
In some bits and pieces, I had watched the movie. And much later, I think when I was like maybe 15 or 16, Raghvi Akka came to know that I was a huge Harry Potter fan. So she decided to gift me the seventh book. And I was like, okay, cool. And I thought, okay,
directly now, read the seventh book. So why are you afraid of spoilers? I mean, what is this? You read Harry Potter seventh book first.
Yes.
Don't tell me that Alice falls the down the rabbit hole, which is like on the first page of the book. I'm like, first page, literally.
Yeah, so I read the seventh book and I was like, now I have read the seventh book. Why do I need to, you know, read all the first six books? No need. I know the end, how it ends.
We just need Harry Potter to know what happens in the end. No, who cares about it?
But in that case, you can just go to Wikipedia and read the plot. No, I don't even need to read the book.
At that time, there was no Wikipedia.
Yeah, so much internet and stuff. But then I think one day.
There was no Instagram.
Yeah, there was nothing. And I think
Wikipedia was there at that time. I know.
Hey, AG is in the chat. Hey, AG, what's up? Are you Potterhead, AG? Can we invite him on the stream?
You mean by Abhijit Gupta? Yeah?
I'm just being polite. Abhijit is also there in the chat. No, I saw Anish.
Oh, okay.
I didn't see
both AGs on the chat.
Okay.
Abhijit conveniently forgotten, yeah? Abhijit has books without me and with Paddu with the sad stripes.
Where is it? Oh, sorry, I missed it.
It
was much long ago when Paddu was telling how she read the seventh book. Hey, Bhaiyu, what's
for
up?
AG.
Oh, Adi is also there. Okay, everyone is watching our stream. Hello.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Okay, now I'm just like, I've broken Paddu's thought process.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
That's
okay.
Bizarre, no? That's like, I've never heard of someone jumping directly to the seventh book.
And why? No. Like, Harry Potter is not about the Harry kills Voldemort. I mean, everybody knows that.
We are not bothering about spoilers today, right?
Everybody has read Harry Potter, I think. I mean, main spoiler. We need not give whether Harry lives or dies.
No, I was around 14 when I started reading Harry Potter. Till that point, I don't think I've read any other book. And Saravan
any
was also
book?
Shocked.
Any
yeah,
other
yeah.
book in life?
Any other book, yeah.
Apart from
like
school.
Okay, apart from Tinkle and Chambak and all those things.
What is this?
I mean, any other serious book. Normal.
I can totally understand because even my parents were not like my father. Parents were very strict and they used to not really encourage me to read all these novels and stuff.
Yeah. Same.
What does that have to do with being strict or not? Like,
no, they are.
Reading
okay, especially my father used to think like, okay, study and, you know, I can do sports and all, but not like play video games or books or any other.
Yeah, actually, kind of similar. And so it used to be difficult for me even to get my hands on these comics and stuff during the train journeys and stuff. So then whenever I got a book, I used to read anything, whatever I could get my hands on. But Harry Potter kept intimidating me because, you know, it looks so huge. It's not actually that big. My course has more words than Harry Potter. So the number of words is small. But it used to be huge, and I used to be intimidated by the size. And of course, if you got shocked like this, imagine Saravanan's reaction when I said I hadn't read any books.
Yeah, like, it's
so
very
he was
strange.
Right there, and he was like, he was also shocked, and he was like, you don't know the joy of reading books. So he sent me, he gave me all these Harry Potter books to read. And I was like this typical teenager, oh no, it's too big for me. I don't read books and stuff. But then I started reading this for the first time, the Harry Potter. And I think within a week, I finished the first six books. It was so addictive.
Yeah, it's unputdownable. You can't stop reading. Like, you want to find out what happens next, no? Like,
exactly. And when I was reading, only six books were released. And then at the end, Dumbledore got killed. And it was such an emotional moment. I was like, what are people going to do now?
Anyway,
how are they going to stop Voldemort?
If someone is born, they're anyway going to die. So it's no big surprise, actually.
Yeah, how are you going to stop Voldemort without Dumbledore? Without the head of Order of Phoenix, the only guy who can stand up to him. The books were written at that time, it was like Voldemort could come anywhere, do Avada Kedavra, game over. And no one can stop him except Dumbledore.
And I was so mad at J.K. Rowling because, first of all, Harry is an orphan, okay? He has, no family. His uncle and aunt are super mean to him. Finally, he gets serious.
Okay,
he's the only hope of a family. His only hope of a family. And he also dies.
Oh.
He also dies. Then Dumbledore, the only person in the world who has always protected him. And then he also dies. And I'm like, this is so mean.
In the stream might not have read the books.
No, I don't think anyone has.
Yeah, I know. There was a Simpsons.
There
was a Simpsons episode where.
But they must have seen the movie, no?
Lisa Simpson is there, no? She also gets this spoiler that Dumbledore dies and she just cannot accept it. It was one of the most. Most tragic moments.
She gets a spoiler that Dumbledore dies and she can't accept it.
Yeah. It was very difficult to accept how Dumbledore could die.
Yeah, like I kept waiting ki nahi wo aa jayega wapas aa jayega aur end tak nahi aaya. Matlab kya like
wo aaya tha na? Aaya tha to.
Wo uske dream mein aaya tha. Kevin's dream.
Yeah, or something.
Yeah, in the purgatory or something like that. Yeah, the in between place between living and death, or within Harry's head.
So guys, what did you like the most about the books? Like, why did you like them? What do you think? Because of magic or what was it?
I think at that time it was so incredibly deep.
Yeah,
no?
I think for me it was a storyline.
Like,
all the characters and everything.
Yeah, like for example, Dementors are analogies for depression. You know, people get these negative thoughts, which is exactly like the how you feel when Dementors are around. And the way to overcome it, the Patronus charm, where you have to channel all the happiest moments you have.
Yeah, you have to.
It's kind of similar to how you repeal depression. And of course, you have chocolates after a Dementor attack. Mm. So I think there were a lot of little analogies there, which were quite deep by J.K. Rowling.
What would be your Patronus?
My Patronus charm, I don't know. I used to think about these things a lot when I was much younger. Now I haven't thought about Harry Potter in many years.
Padu,
yeah, you are first.
Can we have an elephant? Then I'll have an elephant.
Mine was also elephant, but mine was a baby elephant.
Mine, for me, big is also okay.
So I wanted a baby elephant as my Patronus.
Why would you want an elephant?
Okay, it's so cute.
It's so cute, and you just want to hug it and not let it go. Like, and that it will like put water on you with its trunk, and it's like so cute.
Elephant would be so cool.
Yeah.
I don't know. Chat can choose a Patronus for me. Chat, come on.
But what is your favorite animal? Do you have a favorite animal or a bird? Bird can be also be a Patronus.
Yeah.
True. I like eagle.
Eagle?
Yeah. I like tiger.
Tiger is a good pet.
I like lion also. So maybe lion for me. It's not elephant.
Tiger is...
Lion, Simba.
I think I'm more of a tiger than a lion. If I had to, I mean, based on social characteristics. Not based on my strength and stuff. There, I'm lion. Not even like a lion cub or a tiger cub.
You want a lion as your Patronus or a tiger cub? Like, what have you chosen finally? Or like a liger or something?
No.
What have you chosen, Shreena?
Hang on, I'm reading the chat.
Oh, chat is... Cow, kisine bola. Cow, horse.
Someone says cockroach. Why would cockroach be a Patronus? Come on.
Owl.
I'll choose dolphin.
Oh, dolphin is cute. Yes. Dolphin is cute.
It's better to have a Patronus that can, you know, be very swift and jump.
That
any probably anyway, it's not in our choice to have it.
Yeah, yeah. True. It is
a choice to have it. We can decide what can be our
Patronus. Can, with our sheer willpower, we can change it or influence it. But I don't think we can really be like, oh, I want an elephant. That's it.
Yeah, but like if we are like totally affectionate towards an elephant, then that will become our Patronus, no? Automatically. Like, no? Maybe the animal we are like becomes our pet.
Or we something. Are like. Yeah.
Something we have very close connection to.
Yeah. Exactly. Or I'm not like any something animal. We love, like a doe, or someone who has a doe.
Someone we love has a doe.
Yeah, that was also one of the strongest messages of J.K. Arya that. Love is the most powerful magic. And so I think it was filled with a lot of positivity. Mm-hmm. And of course, it also mesmerized us.
What I liked is their friendship. Like, they are so loyal to each other. And
his
friends will like do everything for him. Whether they approve of what he's doing or not is secondary. But if he goes, then they go with him wherever he goes. You know, in the 6th and 7th book, he goes in search of the Horcruxes. And they just, like, they decide they're not going to attend school. They just sacrifice everything to go with him. Yeah.
So what I like the most is how, that friendship. You know, at one point Dumbledore stresses that he's free to share these secrets with his closest friends, which is also
showing the trust.
Yeah, showing the trust, not being a loner, you know, not taking all the burden by himself. Yeah.
Recently also I had some experience where someone was trying to help me and I was like, no, I don't want India too much, you know, being trying to help me and being nice. But then suddenly I had this thought in my mind, what if I just take her help? Yeah. And suddenly the whole attitude and the whole experience shifted for me. And then I thought in general life also, we're always thinking, okay, I can do this alone for everything. But if there is someone who wants to help, sometimes I guess we can let them. It makes things easier.
Exactly. Yeah. I think we don't let people help us because we don't trust them. But then once we, if we learn to trust them, then they can actually help us. That's the problem, right? We don't trust others so much. So we always why should we let them into our world? Something like this.
Yeah, for me, most of the time it is like, okay, I can just do it by myself. I mean, it's okay. I'll just read this by myself. I'll learn this by myself.
Yeah. And sometimes you don't want to get indebted to a certain person. Like, if I do this, then... There are some expectations. So.
And you don't want to trouble sometimes. Sometimes you feel like you're troubling someone and why to... Unke life mein already itna problem hai, hum kyun usko badhaya type, you know. But they want to help us. And even if they don't, like if someone is really affectionate towards you, let's say you are in a problem and they can sense it, yeah? Like they can intuitively sense it. Even if you don't let them help you, they'll anyway be in trouble, right? They'll anyway be... uneasy that they can't help you. So you better let them help you so that they are also fine and you are fine as well.
So they're also happy, yeah?
Yeah.
But they can help you.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think we should just let people be. I mean, let them do whatever they want, even if it means helping you. We take how much we are comfortable with.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it used to be a huge craze at that time.
What, Harry Potter?
Yeah.
And which was your favorite character, by the way?
I liked many. Initially, I loved Dumbledore a lot. But okay. Maybe now that I look back, maybe it's Snape.
Yeah, once you know Snape, maybe, yeah.
Yeah.
Sirius' brother, I think.
Sirius' brother?
Yeah, he was a very nice character. What was his name?
Regulus Black.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this was also one of the things that kept bugging us, you know, after the sixth book.
Who is R.A.B.?
Yeah, who is R.A.B.?
Yeah, let's not disclose R.A.B.'s identity more than...
We already did.
No. More from being, you know, because it's not there in the movies. So someone
really,
was,
it's no, not I there in the
that character is not very well explored in the movies.
No, but movies are dumbed down versions, you know.
Because anyway, you can't fit they, such yeah. a big book in 2.5 hours. So
it's weird. In movies, you just see all these sparks flying and. It's like fireworks and all these things. It doesn't give you that authentic feel.
And all the jokes are cut off, huh? Like, I was very disappointed that half of these Weasley brothers' pranks are not included. I was like, what is this? Like,
they yeah, are yeah, yeah, exactly.
They are the main attraction. Like,
Who was yours? Srinath? And...
Mine Who? Was... No, Srinath said his favorite was Dumbledore, right? And
Severus,
then it
Severus.
Changed to...
Yeah, yeah.
Then now it changed to Snape. It changed to Snape like as an adult or after reading the books?
At some point as an adult, because at some point I came to understand that, you know, Dumbledore is shown as a completely white character. But later I realized that it's not completely white.
Yeah, he's not. And especially
Dumbledore
if you're
not very white.
Yeah. And have you watched Fantastic Beasts? Because in that you see a little bit of, there is Grindelwald, right? In
Fantastic Beasts. But I didn't watch much of the Harry Potter franchise. I only read them.
I have this book, Beetle and the Bard book.
Oh,
so
wow.
It has the stories from the three brothers, you know, of the. It's basically their
the
Grimm's Tale ka version. Wizarding World ka Grimm's Tale hai ye. To unka sab bachpan ka books is tar se.
And who is your favorite character,
Mew? So when I was a kid, it was Sirius. I was in love with him. I thought he's so handsome. And I thought he's like, he's the only family Harry ever had, no? I mean, in the sense of, like not in sense of like a girl, like wife and all. Or like his parents are never a part of the book, only in his memory. So Sirius was the only family ever had, and I was so happy for Harry when he was introduced in the third book. Like, I was so happy, finally he has someone of his own, you know, like he can like go home. He you know that part in third book where he's talking to Sirius about how he'll spend the holidays with him. It's so sweet, like he finally can go to someone for Christmas and everything, and then she just kills him, and I was so
I cried both the times while reading the end of that fifth book.
I cried so much. I was like, this is not this is just not fair. But then now that I look back, I like Harry the most. Like, as an adult, when I look back, I like I think always liked Harry the most. It's just that I thought he's the main character, you know. Like,
Yeah.
You know, automatically you drift towards the side characters. Yeah, like automatically. But I think I like Harry the most because I think he's very courageous. And he's also...
selfless.
Like his life is really tough. Like his life is really tough and he just finds a way to still be happy and see the positives every time. So I think I really like रेगुलर कौन से आया पद्धु तुम मुझे कुछ समझ लाइक मेरे को याद भी नहीं है रेगुलर क्या है मतलब थोड़ा याद है
नो इट वाज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट इन द बुक बिकॉज़ इट वाज लाइक हु इज रेगुलर एंड व्हाट इज हिज स्टोरी इट वाज वेरी कैप्टिवेटिंग ड्यूरिंग दैट पार्ट ऑफ द बुक
बट डिड यू सब्सिक्वेंटली रीड द अदर सिक्स पार्ट्स
Yeah, yeah. So that is one of the things which didn't get spoiled for me from the seventh book, right? Huh. So most of the things back of my mind, I was like, oh, I never felt that much hate towards some of the Snape. Other characters.
For example, you'll never hate on Snape.
Yeah,
I didn't. We all were like, oh my God, how can Snape be so mean? And Padu is like, Snape is so nice.
After reading the seventh book, there was some long gap before I started reading the book from the beginning.
Huh.
And I had forgotten most of the things from the seventh book. Only the towards the end things and somewhere, you know, back of the mind that, okay, Snape is a good character, probably. So I never...
Probably.
I don't know if you're... No, I don't want to be very, you know...
You are everyone seen Harry Potter, Paddu. Trust me, even if they didn't read the book, everyone
And also, Paddu, it's a Soumya's dream. So whatever spoilers you give, she only gets blamed. So feel free.
Yeah, so I didn't feel the hate for Snape at all.
And, exactly. Yeah. You will never hate him, no? You will always, like, always. like, all.
Yeah, so...
Patroness of a dove.
So see, those bits I didn't understand fully when I was reading the seventh book, but I was like, okay, this something is happening. What happens to Harry? That was my main focus in the whole seventh book. And I think once the movies were going to come on the TV from 1 to 7, so I was like, okay, before the movies start, I'll read all the books and, you know, get to know the story before watching the movies. So I started with the first book. And I obviously could not finish the book before the movie started. Like on subsequent days, it was going to come. So I read the first book and then I read the second. I didn't watch the movies, of course, but I read all the books. And then much later, I again read them once more. Yeah.
So you have read them twice, the books?
Yeah, I think so.
And you, Srina, you have read them many times?
Many, many times. I started by reading out everything once. Then I thought 7 was a magical number, so I should finish all the 7 books 7 times. And yeah, then I was going for 7 square.
What?
But okay, of course. Everything 49 times. But okay, I didn't get to that.
Yeah, I also... Some of the books I read more than twice, like Chamber of Secrets and 6th and 7th book probably. But not all.
The first four books, na, mere saath kya hua? So, when I started reading the books, or not all the books were released yet. Only first four books were released. So, I got first four books together. And then for a long time, fifth book didn't come out. So, I used to keep rereading the first four books. Like, 1, 2, 3, 4. Back, 1, 2, 3, 4. My 1, 2, 3, 4. Like, mere ko part ho gaya tha. Like, by heart ho gaya tha first four books. Then fifth book came, sixth, seventh, I didn't read as many times, for example. And also, do you remember, Paddu, were you there at this 2007 Spain trip or you were there in 2008?
For the last tournament, 7.
You were there in Balagar, huh? Yeah. So in Benasque, before that, we were in Benasque, I was reading a fan fiction of the seventh book. And it was really cool. It was really
cool. Yeah, I read a lot of fan fiction.
They had all these different fan fictions, you know, like I remember there was one called Eliza.
Oh, I don't remember the name at all.
Who is Eliza?
Eliza was some character written by a fan fiction.
Okay.
Harry Potter and the Story of Eliza.
Okay, I'll just tell you in advance, if you guys have not read The Cursed Child, don't read it. It's the worst Harry Potter. Like, Harry Potter can get spoiled for you if you read that book.
It is a play, right?
Yeah, it's a play, but I didn't like it a bit.
Yeah.
Oh, the book or the play? You have watched the play or read the book?
No, I have not watched. I wish to watch it, but the book play version I read and I just didn't like it at all.
Okay. I liked the Fantastic Beasts though. Like the first part and Grindelwald I liked. Second part I liked because of Johnny Depp. He's like very like charismatic, right? Like whatever he does, you're like, wow, he has white hair and all that. But first part is like really cool as well, because there are all these interesting animals, and like have you seen them? Like, you should see them. Like, really, you should see them. And especially when the थर्ड पार्ट कम्स आउट, अभी दो ही पार्ट बाहर आया है, तो थर्ड पार्ट जब आएगा तो थिएटर में देखना, लाइक फॉर द इफेक्ट्स एंड एवरीथिंग.
Yeah.
No, I haven't watched.
But where do we have oh yeah, in theaters, you know. Okay, sorry. I just thought like we can watch all these things somewhere live.
Like a play. No, no, no.
But
Cool.
that will probably not be in India, no?
Also, I remember Padu was very disappointed with Ginny's portrayal in the movies, because
Yeah.
I was
They
never a
just
fan of
copy
Ginny.
the character in the movies.
Yeah, I was never a fan of Ginny, but like Padu told me that she was actually much cooler in the books than the movies, but I don't remember it so
Seems
much.
like Bayou loved the curse child. Say
Really?
something
Oh.
about Padu's taste or mine.
But Bayu, did you watch the play or read the book? That's the main thing, no? Because it can be different. Like, maybe the portrayal is what makes it good rather than the story. Padu's getting a lot of messages. Can you see Padu's getting a lot
I'm just
of
checking now. It's very hard for me to be on the stream. I don't know how you guys do it on the stream and read the chat at the same time.
Someone wrote Harry Potter is childish.
No, Harry
So
Potter is the
mean.
best.
I know. Harry Potter is like, oh, actually, even if it's childish, it's okay because it's my childhood. It's everyone's childhood, right? Like, everyone has such nice memories attached to it. For me, Ron and Hermione and Harry were my friends. They were not like characters in the book or something. So, like, especially if you read it as a child, they become your friends, like.
Oh, I
Yeah,
like someone
yeah.
wrote, what about Lupin? I love Lupin.
Ah,
Yeah,
Lupin
I
is
had a crush
great.
on Lupin, I think. And
Ah,
Sirius Black also.
Sirius though is like,
Yeah.
yeah, he was so handsome. And I'm talking about the book description, not the movie.
I like both.
Like, movie also. Is that Inspector Gordon? Nah, he's Inspector Gordon
Yeah.
from Batman. This,
Oh, okay.
huh. Bayu is saying he has read the book. Oh, one more thing. One more character I really liked was this girl, Luna Lovegood. I thought
Yeah,
she was
this
so
way.
quirky and like confident and apne duniya mein mast. She doesn't give a damn. Like,
She's like Phoebe, yeah.
yeah, she's like Phoebe, exactly. She's like Phoebe. How come
Yeah.
you also thought of that? Because I also, maybe she is like Phoebe, that's why. Like, I also thought that she's very much like Phoebe, like doesn't care and just happy person, you know,
Like,
like.
who do you think can give us a Luna Lovegood vibe in our circle, let's say?
Quirky,
In
quirky. You
our circle.
want me to tell you,
No,
no? You want me to tell
no, I thought of you. I actually thought of you. I am not
I
like
would
Luna at all.
to
I think
be
you,
Luna.
yeah, you totally can give Luna
लूना लव
Lovegood
गुड
vibe.
वाइफ. नो, डोंट. अपने दुनिया में मस्त.
Yeah.
थैंक यू, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी हर. यस, शी
By
इज
the
अ
way,
वेरी स्वीट
there's a
कैरेक्टर.
super chat from Asad, yeah. The
ओ
audiobooks read out by Stephen Fry are amazing. It's quite a nice listen to go to sleep or while driving, but not together at once.
ऑफ हैरी पॉटर.
व्हाट? सॉरी,
Yeah.
आई डिडंट हियर
Okay.
इट. व्हाट वाज इट? श्रीनाथ प्रोफेशनल स्ट्रीमर.
The audiobooks read out by Stephen Fry are amazing. It's quite a nice listen to go to sleep or while driving, but not together at once.
Oh, but not together as once
Right.
varliye
I mean, you
enakku.
cannot go to sleep while driving, no?
I thought you shouldn't read it. Okay, fine. Yeah, Luna Lovegood is coming within
Mean, if
in no.
something induces you to sleep and you also do it while driving, that's risky, yeah?
No, that's why he said not to do it at the same time. Yeah.
That was my addition.
No, no, that was Srinath's addition. That's why I didn't understand what he's saying. Abhijit is saying, Abhijit is right actually, but you are saying Harry Potter is like your friends, which you didn't have in real life, but I liked it because of the story. It's actually like that. It's like having your own friends. Like they are like your own friends, which you don't have actually, but you wish you had.
I'm no, quite actually, happy with my friends.
No, actually, yeah. Actually, feel like I felt like I was a part of the book only. That's what is about a good book, no? It makes you feel like you are inside that book. Like it is your own world. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But okay, now that we have kind of grown up, you still think Harry Potter is the best?
Yeah. I actually don't know what is my favorite hobby. Like, they're not like side hobby, yeah? Not like main hobby in life. Yeah, but side hobby is to persuade people I know who haven't seen or read Harry Potter to see or watch it.
High five. I think my friends would go crazy because I would like force them, literally force them to read Harry Potter if they have not read. And they tell me, is it like one of your conditions to become your friend? We have to have read Harry Potter. And I'm not satisfied with watching the movies, okay?
Oh, you want them to read it also. That is a lot of time investment, Paddu.
Yeah, like, I know.
That is a lot of commitment.
Not a lot of time investment, no? Actually, yeah, you, even people who have watched the movies, I don't think they're true Harry Potter fans.
Yeah, they will watch the movies and they're like, oh, I have read, I have watched the movies. Why do I need to read the books?
But if you watch the movie... For example, there is this movie called 7 Years in Tibet. Yeah? It's actually adapted from a book. But once you watch the movie, why would you read the book?
Aisa ho jata hai.
Lord of the Rings also, it's a very good adaptation of the books. The movies are really great.
Hmm.
But I read the books also and it still makes a lot of difference.
Oh, really? So, I never felt... Exactly. So Lord of the Rings is best example. I have only watched the movies. I haven't read a single of those books. And I don't feel like reading them because I loved the movies so much. And I'm like, theek hai, I know what happens in Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, and Harry Potter is like, what, only 20% as good as Lord of the Rings movies.
Yeah.
The movies are terrible.
Yeah. The movies are not terrible. Actually, initially I thought they were terrible. But now I think they're very cute. Like those three kids, you know, in the first year, they're like so tiny, 10 years old.
But so those are just the actors, no? The movie itself was... I didn't like them.
And Emma Watson is so beautiful. I never thought like Hermione will be so girly, you know, like nice girl, like all set.
But Emma Watson is like the perfect Hermione, I think.
Oh, really? Yeah, she's... I was very like surprised. I thought Hermione will have brown hair and will like I always imagined her with buck teeth and
but
like,
that's she's described after the second like book, that, no? After the second movie, I think her buck tooth went away, no?
Hermione too is like
in the book also.
Because of this cat
I
thing.
Never made
because she turns into a cat and her
and she got it fixed by yes. the Madame Pomfrey.
Yes.
Parents are dentists.
Yeah. So her parents never allowed her, but then when she became a cat, she just got it perfectly.
Haan, she's like, "Thi ke ye bhi karwai leti hu, kya hai?"
But that no one noticed until the fifth year.
Yeah. And her time turner was so cool. I used to wish. Oh, one more question. Last question I have. Ki what kind of magic? What power would you want to have from the
book? My all-time favorite and the only wish I have is the having the power of teleportation.
Apparition.
Yeah, that's exactly what I did just before the stream.
But you can't apparent into Hogwarts.
I
just asked the headmaster. I'm
no, so that's why he went outside Hogwarts. He's outside
broomstick. Maybe you went on.
Also,
he's outside Hogwarts, no? So I guess it's possible.
In the forest, you can apparate it.
Yeah.
Ah, correct. true.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm not staying here for too long because there is some variant here also. Since it's in UK. So after the stream, I'm coming right back to India.
Okay, that's nice.
But I
think for you, Harry Potter is set in UK, is it? Like in my mind, it's in another...
No, it's in UK.
Yeah,
I know it's in UK, but like in your mind, it's in UK, is it?
Yeah.
For me, it's not like in UK or something. It's like in another, there is a world where there is Harry Potter. Right?
But that is also in UK, within that world.
Acha, it's within UK.
Yeah.
Cool.
Arre, you guys didn't tell, no? Power. Magical powers about your own.
My favorite magical power, only wish I always have had is packing power. Yeah, you just do this. Yeah. And the pura room clean ho jata hai.
Yeah.
Room clean ho jata hai and everything settles down in your suitcase and everything is like folded neatly. Everything fits into your suitcase, by the way. Even like all your furniture, everything, your whole house you can take with you. And that's it.
Yeah, I
that's
think mine will be that's invisibility my cloak.
Oh. And where will you go, Shri?
Yeah, where will you go? Come invisible.
I don't know. But that's like that's like the one thing that conquers the Deathly Hallows.
See,
and also
the whole point of the story was, even if you have the invisibility cloak or whatever power you have, if you're born, you're going to die, no matter what.
If you have that philosopher's stone,
no, that doesn't help.
Nothing. You can extend your
actually
life.
That gives you, that makes
you. You can extend your life. 700 years you can live.
Yeah, Nicholas Flamel was 474 years old.
But you can live for a really. It was not because of the. Was it because of the stone or he?
Elixir of life.
Yeah, the elixir. Because of the stone, na? Stone has the elixir of life. So.
Yeah. Of course, you can also create horcruxes. That way you won't die, but I wouldn't recommend that.
Yeah, I don't think that's a very good quality.
Yeah, that's not a great way. The way to do it is horrible.
Don't chase immortality, yeah?
Don't chase immortality. Your thoughts can be immortal. Your ideas can be immortal. Then you don't need to be. And your streams can be immortal. They will always be there on YouTube. What? Sorry.
Another Shrinath super chat to emphasize. Please listen to at least one chapter of Harry Potter audiobook by Stephen Fry.
Oh,
his voices for characters are amazing. You will rediscover Harry Potter.
Yeah, I'll definitely listen.
Okay, thank you, Asad. I will try. Actually, for me, it's hard to like look at Harry Potter from another lens, no? Because it's like my own, na? So now to look at it, like let's say he gives another perspective, it will be very difficult for me to read it.
No, I think he will just generally they just narrate whatever is.
Ha! Actually, actually that's true. They just
but
like
in a very nice way.
It's a sound effects and all.
Yeah. I mean, the way you narrate, it can change a lot, yeah. I think Audible has good narration, although I'm not sure.
Sorry, tell me.
No, I got an Audible subscription and then I just forgot about it for several months.
Was it free? Maybe that's why you forgot.
No, it was taking, it was auto-renewing every month.
Yeah, even I was.
How is this going? Where is it going?
And then after 1 month, I didn't use it, so I unsubscribed from it.
But okay, then I called this Amazon customer care and I told them it's getting auto-renewed, but I've never touched it at all. For 4 months, it got auto-renewed. So they refunded the whole thing. So, if something gets auto-renewed and you don't use it, you'll likely get refunded.
Oh, I didn't know that. Useful information for everyone. All of mankind.
For all the muggles.
All the muggles. Asad says no sound effects, just his reading is amazing. Okay, thank you, Asad. Thank you. Cool. Awesome. So this was fun.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Soumya, did you prepare specially for this stream? Were you reading up the books before you came today? Or
no, I was just seeing. Oh, so little bit, like the quotes I, like this. So I remember some things. For example, Harry Potter, I remember. Then I remember Kite Runner as well. I don't know if you saw. Like, I was talking about Kite Runner earlier. So, that also
I
remember.
Yeah, I remember. Actually, Paddu recommended that book to me and I read it.
And Great Expectations.
I can't believe I used to like Kite Runner. I mean,
oh, it's a wonderful book.
It's a wonderful book, but, right? I mean, I just feel at that age, it was probably not appropriate when I read it.
Exactly. What age did you read it?
I was very young when I read it. I don't know. No, I don't know what is young according 15, to you. For 16. Me, yeah, for me, I think I read when I was 15, 16.
Ah, me too. Correct.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, probably. Yeah. Yeah. So what books do you say?
I recommended 5 books. Everyone, like, they're common books, but I just thought to recommend the books which I like. So one was Alice in Wonderland. So that a little bit I was reading because it's so nice. Yeah? I can just like, it's very nice. You should read, everyone should read this, Alice in Wonderland. And I actually feel it's for adults. I mean, not just for kids. Like, it's actually quite philosophical, I feel. And then I recommended Kite Runner. Then Great Expectations by Charles Dickens. Great Expectations, what I actually learned from that book is not like to not judge people, because the characters are so strange in that book, very strange characters. And then Alchemist, and then Harry Potter.
Yeah, Alchemist is also one of my favorites.
Yeah, Alchemist. And I remember you had so basically I had not read The Secret, okay? And how like Paddu had read The Secret and Adi had also read The Secret, and both of them had once recommended the books to me, and I never thought to read it. I thought, kya hai, self-help, mujhe nahi padhna. Aur phir, how Paddu convinced me to read it is, did you read Alchemist? And you know how the whole universe conspires you to achieve it when you really want something? It's the same concept. So I was like, achha. So then I was like, achha, if that's the same concept, then I'll read it.
Yeah. With real life examples.
Ha, real life. But now I don't okay, that's another topic for another day, but I don't really
I think it's a good book and one can read it once at least.
Ha, it's a good book to read once, but like abhi mujhe Secret utna nahi pasand jitna tabhi jab padha tha tab pasand tha, you know.
I remember when all of us had read that book and we used to all have the, you know, put The Secret into effect sometimes for the same things even.
Yeah, I don't remember this. Really?
At least we both had once a clash.
Really?
Yeah.
For the same thing.
Yeah.
And then what happened? Who got it? What was it? I don't even remember. What was it?
I think it was around the same time. When we had read it.
Huh. But I read it after you, no, obviously, because you recommended it to me.
Yeah. So we were returning from some tournament and going to the national championship.
Oh, it was a national championship. Well, clearly I didn't want it. The universe always conspires for me to not achieve it because I clearly don't want.
That's not the whole point of it, is you have to believe it. I mean, you don't, it doesn't matter what universe wants, matters what you want.
True. Padmini, I read a comment, Arush Mohit Mittal says, Padmini looks like a lot, which book Hermione would have looked like? It's true, your hair.
Yeah, I need some gel and stuff to, you know.
No, it looks great. No, it looks great.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Awesome. So, guys, thank you so much. Last way, I wanted some recommendations from chat as well, and from you guys as well, if you have some recommendations in fiction books, because I don't read them anymore. But if you have, then I would like to read. only fiction books, huh, chat? Please give us recommendations for fiction books. Oh, and sure. I also have a recommendation, 1 second I'll give you, which I have also not read, but 1 second I'll just search for it while you think.
Godfather.
Oh yeah, it's fiction. I forgot that it's fiction. Oh yeah, Godfather is fiction.
Yeah.
But I've read Godfather, so yeah, it's a good book. But movie is also good, no?
I didn't watch the movie. Oh.
I have not watched or read both.
But generally, you know, I usually, when I was younger, I used to pick one author and read through all the books of that author and move from author to author.
So yeah, yeah, me
order,
also.
I started with Sidney Sheldon, then Jeffrey Archer.
Ah, okay.
And then Dan Brown.
Hmm.
And a bit of John Grisham.
John Grisham I used to like when I was younger because it had all these his advocate lawyer things. Yeah, so I used
yeah
to
legal, like. Legal thrill.
Rainmaker I really liked. Rainmaker is a cool book.
Rainmaker. Okay, let's not give spoilers.
So one book I wanted to recommend was recommended to me by my 12-year-old niece recently. Villa and the Wood.
What?
Villa and the Wood. I'll write in the chat. Villa and the Wood. Willa. And she said, if you liked Harry Potter, you will like this book. I was like, okay, fine.
Have you read A Song of Ice and Fire?
No.
That is
a
Song of Ice and Fire. Yeah, I think you had suggested it to me sometime back. And Game of Thrones is Song of Ice and Fire, no?
Yeah, it's the adaptation. But again, you know, as we spoke about adaptations and books. And the funny thing is A Song of Ice and Fire, it still hasn't been completed. So even if you haven't started, I think you still have another 5-10 years to start it because I don't think he's going to complete it. It started in 1996, the first book, A Game of Thrones. And the last book in the series, the fifth book, was released in 2011, A Dance with Dragons. And two more books are to come, The Winds of Winter and A Dream of Spring. So not many people are sure if the author will live long enough to complete the books.
What was the name, Srinath?
A Song of Ice and Fire. That is the name of the series.
Oh, seven
book series. It's enormous. It's truly enormous. This has a lot of words, you know, like one book from this series has more words than the entire Harry Potter series combined.
Your Chessable course effect, no? Or depth, average depth of the variation.
Count words.
Yes.
Yeah, I have a whole new appreciation of these authors once I... I think I've written like close to 200,000 words the last 4 months. And the first Harry Potter book, it had only like 70,000 words. So it's not such a big book. The Harry Potter series.
How many words does your course have? Sorry?
Close to 200,000.
That's cool. I had the opposite experience last year. I wrote for a newspaper, okay? I was covering this online Nations Cup. And I had the exact opposite experience that you have to fit your article in 350 words now.
Like Twitter.
So it's like in 350 words you have to say whatever you can about all four boats and the team's performance. Oh my god, it was like I had a whole new appreciation for sports journalists. I was like, oh, now that's why they don't write cover the games very well and like in detail, basically. They don't cover the games in detail because there are only 350 words in the paper and there are space limitations. I think when you have these new experiences, you kind of start to appreciate the hurdles other people face in their job. बोलते वक्त अच्छा इजी लगता है. एंड यू नो इवन लाइक दिस होल क्रिटिसाइजिंग थिंग, लाइक व्हेन आई वाज लाइक व्हेन लाइक एज अ प्लेयर आई आल्सो ऑलवेज फेल्ट लाइक समटाइम्स द वर्ड्स आर वेरी हार्श, यू नो व्हेन यू डोंट प्ले वेल और समथिंग, लाइक नॉट जस्ट फॉर मी बट इवन फॉर लाइक अदर प्लेयर्स in the articles and stuff. And then when I wrote those articles, I realized if you're like, if you always write nice things, even if
then it'll be called Sagar Shah.
Yeah, I mean, you have to at some point like also be objective, right? Like you can't always sugarcoat everything. So it's not easy. Like it's a tricky place for them to be as well, for the journalists. And this angle I had never thought of earlier. So only when you have to be in those shoes, you realize. Jane Eyre, someone wrote. Oh, I want to read The Fountainhead next year.
Oh, a friend of mine gifted it to me for my birthday. That's his favorite book. Yet to start.
Vishnu's favorite book as well. I don't know if it's his current favorite book, but it was for a long time. Yeah. Okay, guys, thank you for your recommendations. Paddu, did you recommend me something?
No. So I think the Harry Potter series are really good. And I think these are the books, at least people should read it once, they like it or not. And I obviously like Lord of the Rings as well. And I think I'll also go with Alchemist. The Secret. Okay,
Secret is not a fiction book. Fiction book.
Okay, fine.
Some people might say it is.
Bhaiyu is saying Godfather. Godfather I've read.
Yeah, great I have book. Not read it. Oh, I used to like a lot of these funny books. And I think it was a very thin book or something. I read it. The Importance of Being Earnest.
Yes.
It's really funny.
Oh, I also used to like them. It's by Woodhouse, P.G. Woodhouse.
Yeah.
Na?
Yeah, and I remember before one of my tournaments, you had a lot of collection of P.G. Woodhouse and yes. I took some books from you.
Yeah, it's full time pass that P.G. Woodhouse. Yeah. Full time pass. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. P.G. Woodhouse is a great recommendation. You can read it in any mood and chill out.
Yeah.
And good for improving your English also, na? Like his language is also very good.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, I mostly like books which, you know, make us believe in belief. Like all this kind of books.
Hope. Full of
hope.
Yeah,
believe in hope. Yeah. So full of.
Okay.
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you.
I was waving to my dad who came to say good night. Don't.
I felt you want to go. That's it.
No.
Which is also fine. I was checking the time. 10:40 ho gaya. I was like, aadha ghanta aa jana stream pe. 10:40 ho gaya. So, thank you. Importance of Being Earnest is Oscar Wilde, not Woodhouse. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
But I remember this book and I also remember you had told me about it, like the story.
Yeah, so both P.G. Woodhouse and Oscar Wilde, both are, I think, they write funny stuff. So.
Thank you, Paddu. Thank you for your recommendations. And thank you, Chad, for your recommendations as well. Chad is a huge fan of... Jeffrey Archer and Dan Brown and
Chetan Bhagat.
Chetan Bhagat recommendations I didn't see, but I saw a lot of recommendations of this guy also, John Grisham also. Like these three authors. Crime and Punishment is also Jeffrey Archer, right?
No. Crime and Punishment is, I think, Leo Tolstoy or some. Dostoevsky or something.
Oh, sorry. क्लासिक को मैंने यू नो इट्स लाइक
जेफ्री आर्चर व्हेन ही केम इन ही वाज हेवीली क्रिटिसाइज्ड फॉर हिज इंग्लिश एंड हिज ग्रामर एंड बट ही वाज वेरी एंटरटेनिंग
एंड यू रेड 1984 एज वेल नो पद्दू
या
यू टोल्ड मी इट वाज वेरी यू हैड पद्दू हैड सेंट मी अ बुक रिव्यू आल्सो
या आई थिंक 2020 वाज अ वेरी डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंस फॉर मी बिकॉज़ आई रेड अ लॉट ऑफ दिस अदर जॉनर where, you know, a little bit of dark books and more probably you people might say it's more realistic and like the real world. So I had some different experience and yeah, I liked the book. So after reading that book, whatever I see and everything, I just see it in a completely different light now.
I wanted to read Animal Farm as well. Have you guys read it?
No.
It's a very heavy book, I think. But I wanted to read that as well. And Crime and Punishment, okay, I might read it. Thank you for the recommendation, Vignesh Subramanian.
I mean, given a choice, would you rather read some books which are recent or classics?
Classics. Why would I read the recent books? Unless they are by my friends. Unless they are by my friends.
So once the recent ones become classic.
Recent books are all, do you know, half the recent books are about love story. Ayyo, so boring. Who wants to read love story? I don't understand.
Yeah, that's true.
Very boring. Have you read any love story books? I have never read.
You mean romance, yeah?
Yeah. Very boring.
Because Harry Potter is also kind of love story book in a different way.
No, like, of course, Great Expectations also has a love story, but it's not like, I don't know, man, like, पता नहीं आजकल तो बहुत सारा लव स्टोरीज है ना आई डोंट नो मे बी ट्वाइलाइट इज अ ग्रेट एग्जाम्पल राइट ऑफ अ लव स्टोरी इट्स ओनली अ लव स्टोरी लाइक दैट्स द मेन पीपल विल बी वेरी ऑफेंडेड आई थिंक ऑल टीनेजर्स मस्ट बी यूज ट्वाइलाइट
आई थिंक ओके मूवीज आर एनफ टू वॉच ऑल दिस रोम कॉम सो वी कैन pair them when we are reading books.
Yeah, exactly. Movies are great for rom-coms. Exactly. Yeah. Aur aise acche bhi dikhte hai wo log. So, eye candy be side by side, eye candy. And like generally it's nice. Many movies I call them as packing movies because you don't need to focus what's happening. People are just looking good on the screen. Achha, gaana wana hai. And you can pack side by side. You don't really need to like concentrate. So...
Yeah, one of the recent, or this packing movie of yours turned out to be really good, no? We watched it together.
Jalebi.
Yeah, Jalebi was fine. No, even that Notebook, was it? It was also a packing movie, no? Or not?
Oh, Notebook. The Hindi Notebook. Yeah. It was a good movie. It was not a packing movie, Paddu. We were very tired. And we wanted to like just sleep. And we just put a movie on the TV. Ki chalo, laga ke so jaate.
There's a Hindi movie called Notebook, is it?
It's very nice.
Yeah, it's a very sweet movie.
It's very nice.
Packing and cleaning movies.
Packing. I have bus movie list also. Like movies which you can watch in the bus. Because they're just funny. Like they don't make any sense. Like full time pass movies. So.
Yeah. I have some eating movies. so that like 5-10 minutes matlab jitna bhi time lagega khane ko but then sometimes I end up watching those movies until the end.
Okay, awesome. Okay. So let's thank our chat for participating. Thank you, chat. Avoid fountain head like you avoid COVID. Aisa mera last super chat hai. Okay, thank you. And let me just read any chats I have missed. Chariots of God, chess with Suyarshin Marathi recommends. Crime and Punishment by Fyodor. Not Dostoevsky. Fyodor Dostoevsky hai kya naam? Pata nahi mujhe. Haan. Theek hai. Thank you, Vignesh Subramanyam. I'll read it. Gaurav Mohite says, he's not happy with my OBS skills. He says it's not fine, crop it from the corners. Okay. And then Dinesh Nimagada says, the Century Trilogy by Ken Follett Fiction gives intricate experience of the 20th century through some bold characters. Okay.
Actually, your OBS canvas looks like this thing where we stick papers and stuff, you know. It's like you've pasted photos of us. you know, there's like a pink chart, right?
Oh, but like a chart paper, like
yeah,
in school.
Yeah, exactly.
But okay, it's fine. Cute.
Yeah. It's nice.
Awesome. So, thanks a lot, guys, for your perspective.
Yeah.
I was
thank
very
you.
Happy.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
I do
you.
Have a port key to catch in 5 minutes, so I will
okay.
see you.
See you,
okay.
Sri.
See you, Srinath.
See you
in India. See you, Meow.
Yeah.
See you, Padu. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Wait, should I end the Zoom call? What should I do?
Yeah.
Oh, Sri,
yeah,
you're still
yeah.
here. Your port key is not yet ready, I guess. Okay,
yeah, it's not yet ready. But yeah, I should be going.
It's fine. You can hang out. I anyway want to just say bye to chat and then I'll end the stream.
Oh, yeah. Sure. No. I'll...
No, it's okay.
I thought the stream was ending.
I'm ending the stream.
Hello, I'll
just...
see you. We'll hang out some other time. Bye-bye.
Oh, okay, fine. okay, bye. Bye, Sri. Thank you. Wait, now I need to adjust this Zoom. It's too big. इसको छोटा कैसे करते हैं? Oh my God, I don't know how to. It's too big, man. Okay. Sorry. Why is it so zoomed in? Weird. Okay, fine. Should be okay. Okay. Death Note is OP. You can try. Bruh says. You're discussing anime. Okay. Okay, chat. Thank you so much. Aapke sab recommendations ke liye. And my friends were like so sweet and मुझे बहुत मजा आया उनके साथ सब discuss करने को और मैं आपके recommendations थोड़े पढ़ूंगी रविंद्रनाथ story someone said okay I have seen some of the movies out of his stories like some of the जो भी रहता है ना क्या रहता है मूवी adaptation of his stories that I've seen this is so awkward मुझे आ नहीं रहा है करने को but okay read it I think I managed anything by Murakami I have read a book by Murakami in fiction I've read one non-fiction also which is what do I think when I think about running It's he writes about his marathon experience, running experience, and a little like it's like some kind of a biography, autobiography. But I read a fiction book by him and I really didn't like it, so I won't recommend it. But yeah, obviously he's like super popular and I have read only one book by him, so yeah, I mean maybe I should read more, but this book I read by him, it was so like disturbing, I can't even tell you. So I don't even want to like name it. I don't actually remember its name, but it was very disturbing and I really didn't like it. But Kafka on the Shore is by Murakami, no? And I think it's very famous. So maybe that one I can read. Okay. Okay guys, thank you so much for all the recommendations. Recommendations chali rahe. Sophie's Choice. Okay. Dune Chronicles by Frank Herbert. Six of Crows Duology. Okay. Theek hai guys, main pad lungi. Thank you. Mujhe bahut maza aaya ye stream karne ko. Aur I wanted to do a non-chess stream for a long time. So That also makes me happy because I think Padu says fun stream thanks everyone thank you Padu it was so nice to hey let's end the stream by one second huh? Guys Just one moment. Let's end the stream by. Array. Okay, wait. My subscriptions. Okay, wait a moment. Oh, yeah. Okay, guys. Let me get something on screen. Yeah, guys, this is Padu's channel. Padu hasn't started streaming yet. I forgot to mention it when she was here. So this is her channel. And let's subscribe to her channel. Let's keep an eye to when she starts streaming. She'll probably upload some videos, maybe. I don't know what's her plan. But she's surely... going to be on her YouTube channel. So please do subscribe to her. I'll paste the link. Wait. I'll paste the link as well. How do I paste the link? I'm such a noob at this, but I'm going to learn today. Anish had taught me how to do it. Let's see if I can do it. No, I can't. Oh, Padu says I'm yet to put something. Yeah, they can subscribe. I think everyone can subscribe, and when you put something, they get the notification. Right? Right, chat? That's how it works, no? So please do subscribe to her channel, and maybe it will encourage her to upload something soon, I guess, like when you see that everyone wants you to stream and upload something on your channel, it sort of encourages you, right? So let's subscribe, and it will be great when she's going to start streaming. She has such a vibrant personality, so it'll be amazing. Maybe in few months I'll put, what is this, Padu? I think, okay, let's keep a goal. Maybe you can keep a goal, like no, it's working. See, Anish taught me this. Control C, Control V, so easy. I have learnt. Yes, guys, let's keep. Abhi kitna hai subscriber? 191 tha. Can I refresh it? Oh, good. 216 already. That's great. And let's subscribe to her channel, guys, and encourage her to start streaming or upload her videos or anything that she wants to talk about, chess, non-chess, it will be great. And on that note, thank you, Janta, for hanging out. Bahut maza aaya. Padu, are you feeling... Why? What is this selfie? What is this smiley? And you don't want people to subscribe or what? Like what? Arre, it's very nice. Okay, no pressure on Padu. We just want to show her our love. Okay, fine. No pressure on Padu. He's like, don't put any pressure on me. Okay, fine, Padu. You start, you can decide to stream whenever you want. And, or not stream. It's up to you. But we would like to be subscribed to you so that in case you want to stream, we'll be notified of it. Okay? Awesome. Okay, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Kitna hua iska? Dekhe ya. Great. Oh, overwhelming emotive. Theek hai, fine. Yes, okay. No, no, no pressure, Patu. You do things at your own pace and whenever you feel like. Anyway, streaming is something I think we should do only if we enjoy it, no? Like, it's not like our main career or something. So, we do it because we like to do it. That's all. Thank you guys for subscribing to Paddu and thank you for watching. Thank you for hanging out. May I be encourage you stream ko. May I be encourage you. Good night. Khana kha lena. May I be khana khaungi jaake. I'm going to have dinner as well. So you guys also have dinner. And like my stream and subscribe to my channel as well. Good night. Good night, guys. Have a nice evening. Oh, just 4 more to 250, Ashwat says. Awesome. Oh, done. Awesome. That's awesome. Bye-bye, guys. See you. Good night.